Supervolcanoes produce massive eruptions that eject ash and pumice at supersonic speeds. These eruptions, they leave large craters in the ground called calderas, and they tend to get a lot of attention. But what happens after the eruption beneath the surface? We're particularly interested in something called resurgence. It's a post-eruption process where the leftover magma pushes up the caldera floor, and that forms a dome. What we're trying to figure out is why and when does this happen? When does it start? How long does it last? Knowing these things is crucial to understanding future volcanic activity, and I've been studying the Toba caldera in Sumatra to learn more. To understand resurgence, we have to go back to the beginning of the eruption process. First, the magma builds up in the reservoir. It collects under the crust due to buoyancy, and this can take anywhere between 100,000 to a million years. As the volume builds up, the crust bulges and fault lines begin to form. Once these fault lines intersect the magma reservoir, the pressure is released and you end up with explosive results.
And under those conditions, the gases that are contained in the magma come out of solution and they form bubbles. And those bubbles want to rush out to the surface. And the way to think of that is when you open your pop bottle, the gases that are dissolved in the pop suddenly come out of solution and form all these bubbles. And if you've shaken it up, then you're going to get a big mess.
During this eruption, the column of ash, gas, and rock, they shoot miles up into the air. And at the same time, the roof of the magma chamber collapses and creates the caldera. This process takes typically less than a week. The collapsed caldera causes the trapped magma in the reservoir to compress. If the supervolcano is in a wet environment, rain can collect in that caldera and it forms a lake. Toba's lake formed in about 1,500 years. When the magma re-expands to reach equilibrium, the caldera floor is pushed up to form a dome. And 30,000 years ago, its resurgent dome emerged from beneath that lake surface.
And the way to think about this is if you have a block of wood, and the block of wood would float in water. If you press on that block of wood, you can cause it to sink into the water, but the moment you release the force, the water flows back and pushes the block of wood.
I'm interested in understanding resurgence at Toba because the island is home to roughly 100,000 people, so helping to educate and engage the citizens about resurgence will be crucial going forward.